Let us pray.
Our Lord and our God, we thank you, Lord, for the gift of another day. We thank you, Lord, for watching over us. We thank you, Lord, for we are your creature, Almighty God. That it is only in your hand, Lord, that we are safe and secure. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, because you are God, you are all in all. You will guide us till the day is done. Everlasting Father, be thou magnified, O Lord, now and forever. Thank you, Lord, for forgiving us our sins. Thank you, Lord, for washing us with the water of your word. Thank you, Lord, for making us righteous so that we can approach the throne of grace this morning. Thank you for the opportunity that you give to us to come together, Lord, to worship you, to use our gift to edify one another, to learn from you, Lord Almighty, so that we can change, so that we can be useful in the hand of the Master. We commit everything that we are going to do today, Lord, into your hand, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Take preeminence in the name of Jesus. Speak to us as an individual and speak to us as a group. Thank you for the grace that has been bestowed upon us so that we can not just be the hearers of your word, we can be doers so that we can be blessed. We commit the rest of the day into your hands, Father. Have absolute control in the name of Jesus. Speak through us, think through us, see through us. Let us continue to be the light that shine in the midst of the darkness of this world. Use us, O Lord, to the glory of your holy name this day. Thank you, Lord, for always hear our prayer, because we pray in the name that is above every name, and the name that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Father, we have prayed this morning with thanksgiving. Blessed be your holy name. We worship you. We thank you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We thank God so much this morning. You're welcome. Good morning. Welcome to the Friday edition of the morning devotion. And now we will go before the Lord and sing praises and worship him.
Hallelujah. Young people, there's nothing wrong with dancing for Jesus. But we can't forget where we come from. So come on, let's have a little church right now.
Something about that name.
Thank you, Jesus. Listen.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes, I say.
It is the sweetest name.
Come on and lift your hands and say
it. It is the sweetest name.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know.
Listen to this right here.
Some people say I'm crazy, but I can't explain.
No, no.
The power that I feel, oh, when I call your name.
When I call your name.
Said it's just like. Shut up in my bones.
Oh,
dang, the Holy Ghost is moving here.
Yes, it is.
And it just won't leave me alone. Oh, there's something. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Something about the name.
Yes, it is.
Something about the name.
Oh, I realize
it is
a sweet.
Sweeter than honey.
Oh,
oh,
wait till the fire comes. You can all shout, praise him, do it now. Oh, 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 yeah, 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 yeah.
Something about the baby.
My sin was great, your love was greater.
Amen. We thank God so much for that wonderful time praising God, just telling him of what he is worth. Now we will go into our general prayers this morning. Our general prayers will be brought to us by Sister Winifred. You're welcome, Sister Winifred.
Good morning. Thank you. Good morning. Today we're going to be praying together for this morning devotion platform. We'll be praying to God to make this platform an altar of transformation. We're praying to God to make this platform an altar of transformation. Now we go to prayer number one. It says, Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for always sending your word on this platform, thereby making it a green pastures where the saints are nourished and refreshed. Let us pray. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for your word. Thank you for your word that quenches our spiritual thirst and hunger. Thank you for sending your word, which refreshes us daily. The psalmist says, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still water. We say, thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Lord, for your word, the food of life, just as the deer pants for the water brooks. Father, may we continue to pant after you. Pant after you, pant after your loving kindness, pant after your word and your living word in the name of Jesus. Father, we just want to thank you. We want to thank you. His word says, enter into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. We thank you, Lord, for your word. Let it fill us as we feed on it. Father, let your word fill us, because it is the bread of life. Lord, we thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now we go to prayer number two. Prayer number two says, Father God, in Jesus' name, search my inward parts and know my heart. Purge me, cleanse me of any wicked way, transforming me inside out in the name of Jesus. Dear Lord, you know me. You know my heart. Nothing is hidden from you. I surrender for your deep cleansing. Wash me, O Lord. Wash me with your precious blood and make me clean. The psalmist says, purge me with hyssop and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow. Dear Lord, cleanse me and lead me in thy way to go, O Lord. By the power of your word, I pray this morning, so I can please you. For only those that had clean hands and pure hearts, who had not lifted up his soul into vanity or sworn deceitfully, can stand in your holy place. Father, make my ways be acceptable unto you. Thank you, Father. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts, and see if there's any wicked way in me, and lead me, O Lord, in the way everlasting. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Now we're going to pray at number three. Prayer number three says, Father, in the name of Jesus, continue to send us your word on this platform in exceeding dimensions the remaining days of this year, leading to the explosive growth in Jesus' name. Loving Father, thank you. Thank you as you continue to send us your word daily on this platform. Let your word, let it be a lamp to our feet and a light to our path, to bring changes to our lives that will transform us, to make us stand firm, not to yield, not to conform to the pattern of this world, but by renewing of our mind in the mighty name of Jesus. Acts 7 says, and the word of God increased, and the number of the disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly, and a great company of the priests were obedient to my faith. May your word continue to find expressions in our lives, O Lord, making us witnesses for you, to bring increase and enlargement into your kingdom. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Now we go to prayer number four. Prayer number four says, Father, in the name of Jesus, let your word grow mightily on this platform, thereby establishing our dominion individual as we prevail in our daily dealings. In the name of Jesus, Father, let your word grow mightily. Heavenly Father, we pray for more of your word. Let the power of your word, let it polish us. Polish us so we can shine for you. Let your glory and power be seen in our lives, for your name alone to be glorified. In the name of Jesus, let your word grow mightily on this platform, dear Lord. Acts 19:20 says, so mightily grew the word of God and prevailed. Lord, your word is strong, mighty, and powerful. Let your word, let it pierce through to circumcise our hearts. Hebrews 4:12 says, for the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and of spirit, of joints and of marrow, and discerning the thoughts and intentions of the heart. Father, we thank you. Thank you, King of Glory, for you have given us dominion, power, and authority over every situation and over our enemies. We pray that you continually give us deep understanding of who we are in Christ, as your word calls us victory and overcomer. Thank you, Father. Anoint us with the power of your word. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen. Now we are going to prayer number five. Prayer number five says, Father, in the name of Jesus, by your Holy Spirit, grant us supernatural insights in the word to all participants on this platform, resulting in supernatural breakthroughs in our lives, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We thank you as you continue to open the eyes of our understanding to your word. Give us more revelations of your word daily on this platform, and the power to begin to manifest walking in your word, in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 61 says, arise, shine, for the light is come and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth and the gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon thee and his glory shall be seen upon thee. And the Gentiles shall come to thy light and kings to the brightness of the rising. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. Thank you, dear Lord. May we arise. May we arise and begin to shine. May we arise and begin to take our places, take dominion by that power of your spoken word. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Now we go to prayer number six. Prayer number six says, Father, by the Holy Ghost, let your word have a free course and be glorified among us on this platform with evidence of signs and wonders in Jesus' name. Your word in 2 Thessalonians 3 says, I finally, brethren, pray for us that the word of the Lord may have free course and be glorified even as it is with you. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your word we receive daily. As we receive, may we believe it. Because your word that we believe is that that works in us. Ephesians 6:17 says, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of spirit, which is the word of God. Father, we thank you, for your word is not the word of man, but your spoken word, which comes with power and anointing that breaks every yoke. We give you all the praise. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And we go to the last prayer, which is prayer number seven. It says, Father, in the name of Jesus, let the divine utterance be granted to the ministers of your word on this platform, leading to its supernatural impact on the lives of all participants. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Our Father, our God, grant all our ministers and pastors on this platform divine utterance to be able to speak your word in due season. Fill them, O Lord, with the power of your Holy Spirit for your spoken word to bring breakthroughs and deliverance to all the participants on this platform and to all men. 2 Thessalonians 3:1 says, finally, brethren, pray for this that the word of the Lord may have free course and be glorified even as it is with you. Father, we thank you. Thank you for your word, which says, behold, I have put my word in your mouth. But when I speak to you, I will open your mouth and you will say to them, thus says the Lord. Now, let your word have free course among us on this platform so your gospel can be spread among all men in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Omnipotent God, we thank you. Thank you for the truth of your word that we receive daily on this platform. Your word in Colossians 3 says, put on your new nature and be renewed as you learn to know your creator and transform by the power of your word. And may we, O Lord, continue to keep pressing on, gaining new heights every day, pleasing you in the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Amen.
Amen. We thank God for the prayers. We thank God for the answers to the prayers. And now we'll go into our Bible reading this morning. Our Bible reading is taken from Hebrews 11, verse 17 to 40. Hebrews 11, verse 17 to 40. And our sister Claire will be reading for us. You're welcome, Claire.
Good morning, family. This is Hebrews 11, 17 to 40. By faith, Abraham, when God tested him, offered Isaac as a sacrifice. He who had embraced the promises was about to sacrifice his one and only son, even though God had said to him, "It is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned." Abraham reasoned that God could even raise the dead, and so in a manner of speaking, he did receive Isaac back from death. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau in regard to their future. By faith, Jacob, when he was dying, blessed each of Joseph's sons and worshiped as he leaned on the top of his staff. By faith, Joseph, when his end was near, spoke about the exodus of the Israelites from Egypt and gave instructions concerning the burial of his bones. By faith, Moses' parents hid him for 3 months after he was born because they saw he was no ordinary child, and they were not afraid of the king's edict. Sorry. By faith, Moses, when he had grown up, refused to be known as the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He chose to be mistreated along with the people of God rather than to enjoy the fleeting pleasures of sin. He regarded disgrace for the sake of Christ as of greater value than the treasures of Egypt, because he was looking ahead to his reward. By faith, he left Egypt, not fearing the king's anger. He persevered because he saw him who is invisible. By faith, he kept the Passover and the application of blood so that the destroyer of the firstborn would not touch the firstborn of Israel. By faith, the people passed through the Red Sea as on dry land. But when the Egyptians tried to do so, they were drowned. By faith, the walls of Jericho fell after the army had marched around them for 7 days. By faith, the prostitute Rahab, because she welcomed the spies, was not killed with those who were disobedient. And what more shall I say? I do not have time to tell about Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, and David, and Samuel and the prophets, who through faith conquered kingdoms, administered justice, and gained what was promised, who shut the mouths of lions, quenched the fury of the flames, and escaped the edge of the sword, whose weakness was turned to strength, and who became powerful in battle and routed foreign aid armies. Women received back their dead, raised to life again. There were others who were tortured, refusing to be released so that they might gain an even better resurrection. Some faced jeers and flogging and even chains and imprisonment. They were put to death by stoning. They were sawed in two. They were killed by the sword. They went about in sheepskins and goatskins, destitute, persecuted, and mistreated. The world was not worthy of them. They wandered in deserts and mountains, living in caves and in holes in the ground. These were all commanded for their faith, yet none of them received what had been promised, since God had planned something better for us, so that only together with us would they be made perfect. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen. Amen. Thank you for the reading of the word. And now we will go to receive the charge from our Pastor Tunji. You're welcome, Pastor Tunji.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. We thank God again for another time. We're still on the subject of faith, and today we just round off with the power of faith. I remember about 3 years now, I just started speaking out some words of faith, and I wrote it out. Now, read it first. I said, faith is a beautiful thing. It gives hope to the hopeless. It brings joy and laughter to the sorrowful. It defines a bright future. It secures peace with God and anchors itself in the divine. Faith is a beautiful thing. Every covenant child, that is the child of a child of Abraham, is entitled to the blessing of Abraham. But it's by this beautiful thing called faith. Remember, we read Galatians 3:13 and 14. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. But listen to verse 14. It says that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. It's all through the power of faith. We are, as children of Abraham, we are entitled to the blessings of Abraham, but then through faith. Through faith. Romans 5:1, therefore being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Glory to God. It's always by faith. Without it, we can't please God. For he that will come unto God must believe that he's God. Must believe. You have to believe to be rewarded. So what is faith again?
Ooh. He wants to get up.
He just got up. Hallelujah. John 6:28, we said something like about it yesterday. They said unto me, what shall we do that we might walk the works of God? They say, go pray, go fast, go do this. They know. He said, this is the work of God, that you believe on him. That you believe. That's the work. That's why my bishop will always say, faith is hard work. Oh, faith is hard work. This is the work of God, that ye believe on him, whom he has said. That's the work. The real work is believing on him, believing him for his word, believing everything he says, believing him in who he says you are, believing him in who he says he has made you, believing him. That's the real work. Because faith is displaying your conviction of him. This all died in the faith, not having received the promises, he said. That's talking about men of old. We just read how they are completed by us today. He said, but they have seen it. They were persuaded of it. They embraced it, and they began to speak it. Their conviction. Paul said, we cannot but speak of the things which we have seen and heard. I mean, Peter. They were holding on to their convictions of God, of his word. Even when everything was contrary. Because faith is committing yourself to your convictions and persuasion by the word of God. There is always a command to obey, to provoke God's intervention. That's why it takes faith to draw the ability of God. Like we said, faith is practical expression of confidence in God and His word, because it is always by grace but through faith. Grace makes it available, faith accepts it. Always by grace but through faith. Hence, we are commanded to hold on fast to that which we have believed. Cast not away your confidence. Because faith is an expression of confidence. Glory to God. Faith is what made us overcomers. For whatsoever is born of God that overcomes the world, and this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. God is sovereign. Is almighty. There's nothing he can't do. But he will only do that which our faith procures. It's faith to draw on his ability. Whatever is subduing you, making life uncomfortable for you, lording it over you, it's an indication that your faith in that area of life is not there yet. So go build it up. We just read from Hebrews today, who through faith subdued the kingdom? Who through faith wrought righteousness? Who through faith obtained promises? Who through faith off the mouth of lions, who through faith quenched the violence of fire. All were done through faith. The exercise of their faith. We've read so much about all these great men and women of God. It's time men and women read of us. That is, of our acts of faith. If you are a child of God, you have overcome already, like we said yesterday. But then you prove the reality of that by your faith. Glory to God. So when he saw their faith. Faith is our only way of rescue. Not the crying, the tearings and all that. No. It's standing in your place of faith, walking the walk of faith, and allowing your faith to secure it. The way of faith is our only way. He said, only believe, because all things are possible to them who believe. The battles of life are essentially, for a child of God, battles of faith. We are faith people. Hear what Nebuchadnezzar said. We already know that he said about the three Hebrew children. He said, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and delivered his servants that trusted him. His servants that believed in him. Those are the ones he delivers. And by the operation of their faith in him, he changed the king's word. You should know what that means, because the king's words are naturally unchangeable. But by your faith in action, God changed it. Delivered his servant that trusted in him, that believed in him, that have faith in him. He that believeth on him, the Bible says, shall not be disappointed. And I've changed the king's unchangeable word. Faith does that. By faith, you can change any situation. Glory to God. Can change it by faith and has changed the king's world. But remember, in closing, faith is your responsibility. You have to build it. You have to acquire it. For he that cometh unto God must believe. You are the one to believe. If thou can believe, if you can just believe, all things are possible to him that believes. That job. We've talked so much about the offering of Cain and offering of Abel and all manner of theology on it. But Hebrews 4:11 makes it very clear. By faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain. That means even in your offering, your sacrifices, your gift, faith must be on the line for you. I go out by faith. My bishop will say, God is all you need to command supernatural increase. And faith is all it takes to get God to work. And understanding is all that faith needs to come alive. I repeat that. God is all you need to command supernatural increase. And faith is all it takes to get God to work. And understanding is all that faith needs to come alive. So let your faith come alive. Faith in God. Oh, Master, the fig tree which you cut yesterday is withered away. He said, have faith in God. And he went on further to tell them that with your faith in God, there is nothing you cannot do at all. Faith is always backed up by your action. So check your actions to see whether their actions motivated by faith or not. Glory to God. And to act. Put our faith to work in your life. I trust God that today He will do a strange thing in your life that men will gather to celebrate with you. But faith is speaking today. Faith is speaking today. That faith is taken away today because faith is speaking today. That lump that they are still looking for how to surgically remove and still be talking about it is taken away today because faith is speaking. He touched her and the fever left as the thought of faith. He touched him and the blood turned. That's the thought of faith. Others were tonguing. It makes no difference. It's your faith. Every of the solutions, situation that has defied. And you are at a crossroad today, not knowing what to do next, because you're just there. You can't, nothing is working again. It's not working. And that expected act of shame is staring you in the face. Your mind running all around to all the scenarios of what will bring shame. But today I say in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will not see it. Because he that believeth shall not be confounded. He that believeth shall not be put to shame. That shame that the enemy has been threatening you with. You can't sleep well. Your mind is choked. You will not see it. Glory to God. No. Finally, that God is God. Getting it done is not the problem. It's just waiting for you to turn the platform of your faith. put your faith out. Speak the language of faith. Bring yourself to that point of believing. Because all things are possible to him that believes. You will not see shame. And I'm saying it again, what the enemy has threatened you with is there in your face. Every evidence on the ground confirms that this is it. It will bring you shame. You will not see it. For Elisha said, by this time tomorrow. And that man began to say, what are you talking about? Even if God were to open the windows of heaven, shall these things be? But by this time tomorrow it was. No, it will not happen. That shame, you will not see it. Let not your heart be terrified. Believe God. Say amen to it. Speak it out. I will not see shame. Believe God. Because he has done it already. Glory to God. Now we go before the Lord in our personal moment this morning. I like the affirmation of your faith in the things before you. Speak to it. He said, you shall say to this mountain, speak to it. You're tired of Abraham. Victory is yours already. Jesus secured it, like I said yesterday. And you put your faith on life for every other thing you are bringing before the Lord today. I tell you, before the sun goes down today, the answer is in your hand. Let's go before the Lord. We'll be back together shortly. Jesus, Lord. The Lord Jesus.
Amen. We thank God so much for bringing us to the end of a great week. We thank God also for the teaching on the on faith. I'm so captivated by Hebrews 11, where it says that talking about all these heroes of faith, and yet it says that whose weakness was turned to strength, that by faith, whatever it is that is a weakness for you, it can be turned into a strength. And so I thank God so much. That really captured my heart when the reading was done, and just to be amazed at God's ability. So whatever we put in the hands of God by faith, that he can turn it into greatness, no matter how weak it is. And so whether it be illness or whatever situation you're going through, that by faith, you can overcome it. You know, and it, just the whole chapter is so captivating to see the things that were done. And I also like the part that says, and we don't even have time to speak of all these other people. And then they just go ahead and mention a few and say, and the prophets. And so they lump them all together and say, there's just way too many people. And the word of God encourages us, saying we have such a great cloud of witnesses, all that have gone before, that have gone through all these things by faith, and they are cheerleaders. And so we really thank God for this word, because it's such a word of encouragement. Faith is the currency of heaven. We can do nothing without faith. And so we thank God, and we honor him for the word that has been brought to us to encourage us, to bring us what we need to strengthen ourselves in everything that we are praying about. Because even what we pray, if we don't believe, then we cannot receive. And so I thank God for that. We thank God for bringing us to the end of another great week in his presence. And so as we go into the weekend, let's just meditate on the things that we have learned this week, the things that have been spoken, and also to practice them, because the word of God, if we don't put it in practice, then it's just, we're just hearing. And the hearing is not enough, because we have to do in order to attain the things that have been promised of us. We have to exercise. So step out in your faith boldly and see what God can do, because that's really what it is. We just step out and see what he can do. And if things don't turn out the way we want it, then we try it again. We keep coming back, because we have already been promised. Everything has already been given. We just have to go get it. So we thank God for this platform. You're welcome again to join on Monday. Please invite as many people as you can. Share the beauty of this platform with everyone that you run into, because we are receiving so much. We are soaking into the presence of God. And every morning we come, I know I never leave the same. I know I have heard the voice of God in prayer on this platform through the messages, and I'm sure you have too. So your testimony is what will bring others. Just tell people about yourself. You don't have to make it up. You don't have to think about what to say. Just share your experiences, and God uses that to draw people to himself. So we thank God for that. So we'll meet again on Monday morning, 5 a.m. Mountain Time, to continue rejoicing in the presence of God and learning and having encounters with him. So we thank God. As you go, let me give you this blessing. As we have read concerning faith, that may God turn every weakness, every situation in your life that seems impossible, as you face it with faith, as the Bible says, that even some of them were quenching the fury of the flame. Okay, so quench the fury of that flame of the impossibility in your life by faith, and see how God will step out for you and fulfill the things that you have asked of him, that you have waited upon him for. We thank God for that. And now let us share the blessing. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you.